Hello YouTube. I recently visited a retro gathering in Gothenburg. The main focus was repairing and building your retro computers. There was also a lot of trading going on. I myself scored a few motherboards and a graphics card and other components. We spent some time playing some computer games online, and then we spent some time overclocking some old classical processors like the Celeron and Pentium 3 Teletins.
Det är bara
fred. Folk som är duktig på det.
Det är så små barn med.
Det är fan inget roligt.
Ja, det är så små barn med, så det är liksom spanar för fan jag andas fire direkt. Ibland dör du innan du ens inte
ja.
Svänger den.
So I'm on the slam here, and I found this Tyan. Let's see here, it's an S2466 board that I did a trade that I bought. Good deal with two CPUs. It's untested, but it was so cheap, so a single CPU would be worth it if it works. So, gonna try that at home, get some heatsink and some RAM. So it has 4x8GP, two full-length PCI slots, 64-bit, and on its own bus, and then got 4 33 MHz 32-bit slots. That's pretty nice. As far as I know, these ports aren't particularly great. It has the USB bug, so I don't know if this USB port works or if I had to add a card and so on. The kind of finicky boards, but it's kind of cool with a dual CPU board, I think. So, kind of hope for the best. See if you can build something out of this at some point and make a video of it. So, from the same person, I also bought this one for steel, I would say. It has some bad caps, I think. They've been replaced before, so it should work probably. The heatsink here was missing, but I found one from a dead motherboard, so put that on here. So this is a LAN party board, but used by someone who was overclocking, and he was sponsored apparently, so this was one of two surviving board. Here's a number of these apparently, so hopefully this is a good overclocking board when they're fixed. The caps, like I said, are probably bad. They have been replaced at some point before, some of them, so yeah, it's an Enforce 2 Ultra 400 board. So, with some luck, maybe 500 MHz bus. I'm up to 470 on my ass rock, but this should be better. So, a bit limited on space on the socket, but maybe water cooling, that should have been an issue then. And it's 12 volts, it seems, so that's nice. Can use a modern power supply with this. I'm going to have to try to find a decent old one. Other than that, yeah, it's not that. Pretty scarce other than that. It has the SIL T114 SATA controller, so it has two, basically onboard and force one plus the two force plus that, so that's kind of nice add-on. So yeah, probably gonna upgrade my Atom XP with this board if it works out. So there will be a video on this at some point too, I think. Gonna fix this up and see how far we can push it. And I got a hands on this card. It's artifacting, it's like a donor card basically. So, but I need the memory chip, so at least some of them hopefully gonna be good, so I can use that for fixing another card. And it's an ordinary Realtek 8139. I'm out of those, so it's kinda nice. So I got those two here. This was three, and I think this was, yeah, this was three too. One of the three pile of stuff giving away. I was also given a sort of motherboard with was this another 350 MHz G4 CPU. Caps are swollen, so kind of happy I recapped my board in my working system because this one has bad caps. So apparently they seems like they're going at some point. So this might make a good spare board once I recap this one and tested it, make sure it works and recap it. So could be nice to have a spare board. It's slightly abused, but nothing serious. So need some cleaning. And I was given this board. It needs recapping. There's a lot of bad caps, but yeah, other than that, so I think we should save it. I'm not sure what model it is, see if we can find out. ASMV8 actually had an identical one with new caps lying at home, so... So this has a CPU in this board too. It's a 2600 plus, so... Probably a 266 plus CPU. So yeah, no, actually I have two of these boards I need to recap. So yeah, at some point I'm gonna do both of these boards. So it's a 323 megabit bus and it's a VIA chipset. So. This is a 6200 with bad caps. Probably a good practice card to like remove and add stuff back just to see if it works. It's, like otherwise it doesn't have any real value. And here is a... what was this card? CT6850, Creative Labs. I'm not sure. But there's probably something broken with this. Yeah, the membership is broken. I don't know if it's only fault. Most things here are broken. This is a... See, Savage 4. Yeah, probably something with the member 2 according to our owner. What is this? Inno 3D MX440. Probably broken too, practice card or spare part. Intel 740. This one is, well, I got this from the broken pile, the broken box, so it's probably broken, but I would like to fix it if I can. I don't have a 740 actually. It's not like it's a great card, but it's not a bad card either. It's just historically interesting, so I want to fix it if I can, but I don't know what's wrong with it. Voodoo 2, really bad shape. It was one like a rip-off, seller ripped them off, basically. I got it. So it's really like real abuse, like the whole ship seems to have been twisted and knocked around, so that it's dead, but maybe, I don't know, maybe something can, like technically probably repaired, but if it's worth repairing off, but maybe the memory is good or something, you can use that, so yeah, really bad shape Voodoo 1, really bad shape on the ships and so on. This is also 3D FX. Plus the Banshee. So Voodoo 2, really bad shape. No pins left. So, and no pins here, so really, yeah. Like anything can be fixed, but that's gonna be a pain to try to fix. Memory might be useful for something. And yeah, seems like someone have left in salt water for like a month. So yeah, really bad shape for the two, but parts also. These seems like they've been left outside or something, like in the garage at the very least, also totally rusted. So. And yeah, missing traces, missing ship. If that isn't a broken Voodoo 2, then I don't know what is broken. Also, that ship is also completely knocked out of place. But a good source for memories, maybe. They look in good shape at least. So, three donor Voodoo 2s. And another broken, possibly. Also, 3DFX card. So, yeah, a whole bunch of broken 3DFX card that can be used to fix other ones that has less severe defects, I hope. Yeah. So this is like what I received for free to try to use to repair or upgrade other cards. Jag tänkte jag var med och klockade lite sen, tänkte jag, men du kan få gå med sådär. Det blir ingen lång film om jag gör någonting. Jag har intro så hör jag när jag vad jag har fått för tag för delar så blir det typ, ja ah, visst, då blir det din mage. What are you doing, Timmy? What are you doing? What are you actually doing? What are you running?
I don't speak English.
Oh, fuck you.
Så här är Timmy, jag spackar sig Dutch. Säger man.
So, now we have 11,190 score with a 10,313
1266 at 1,603 megahertz. RAM at 133, I think. Yeah. That's two. Also timings, Kali 2. And we got the GeForce 2 Pro. At 232 megahertz GPU and 480 megahertz memory. So that's a pretty good score. It's about 1,000 off with similar hardware with the GeForce TF500, we think, from two years of test. So, pretty good. Should we try the 166-166 just to see how the score compares?
Yeah,
do it. Okay. Oh, you're full. Just about full. Kör vi den? 7-9. 22-2-2-9. Nu har det 7-9. HP, jo, jag kommer förbi det i alla fall, det är bra att börja. Så vi kommer in och Windows här. Jag fattar inte de sista ger så mycket.
Jag köper en engagare med 160
plus. Ja,
men det är överspännings...
Ja, det är skitgrymt. Ska bara in i Windows och kolla CPU-sätta. Och är det rätt så kör vi benchmark. Och när jag kör benchmark...
Jag ska bara sätta tecken och skärmen och så här. Ja, det kommer fan in.
Ja, bra. Jag ska ut och sånt smoke med, men jag tänkte den benchmark.
Jaha, uppstämt.
Nej. Ja, det var bara... Jag tror det var en cool bit som kickade in här. Ja, den får sådär. Men tänk så jävla fort i D-kontrollen när du går istället. Det är den där 8-66, va? Ja. Så nu går det liksom 8-88 som inte finns. Det är nästan 8-100. Nu är det. Minne, memory. Den är 66,7-1-2-2-2-7-9. Så det verkar ju som att det är de två som inte funkar. Så på mätta målkortet så blir det inte, antagligen lite minne då. Minneskontrollen gillar inte 5-7. Men minnet gjorde det på denna målkortet, så det är ju... Sen har vi aldrig verifierat en sticka som stabil nämntest. Det där är bara 3D Mark som vi vet att det gick igenom på din målkortet. Jag tror inte det är nämntest.
Jag kör runda och ser vad du landar på.
Ja, jag tänkte att jag ska göra det. Jag ska göra så här, men innan jag stoppar med oss ska jag sänka upplösningen och plocka lite grejer så. Vi ska ja, vi tweakar inte GPU just nu, vi ska bara få jämfört. Vad är det? 11.1 va? 11.1.
1-1-1-1-60
tar tid. Ja. Jag ska bara ta och gå upp lite, men du kan ja, spara ett stort. Jag måste bara röra på mig lite, jag börjar sen kolla på längden.
Jag väntar på mig.
New custom benchmark change.
Det är bara att välja som du får till.
Nej, jag tror, du kan ju sitta och kolla, men jag tror vi har slått det kortet. Vi har nog stått det, men det kortet har nog stått på det gamla rekordet. Men vi kan inte slå det maxrekordet på det kortet.
Jag når inte riktigt samma som dig.
Nej, du är inte Adam heller. Men det bevisar vem som är den bättre överklockare. Han är bättre överklockare, vi konkluderar. Because Timmy here and Adam gets beaten by 2,000 points.
I only have a GeForce 2 GTS and a CR 1,000.
Men
procentuellt så är jag högre än det i alla fall.
På vad? Jag kör 1,000 i 1600.
Det är
jättebra. Det är mer in innan. Så nu vet jag att det är snabbare. För innan vi har 300 poäng med. Vi gör så här. Det här GeForce 3. Vi vet vad vi gör nästa gång. Nästa gång får de välja GeForce 3 vi kommer. Nu ska vi knäcka 13 000. Det borde du kunna göra på äsken.
Kanske.
So, now we're running 1,583 MHz, but we're running a memory speed of 166 MHz instead. So we're running, what is it, 100, no, like a 90 MHz less or something. But 37 MHz faster than memory, and we're up 300 points compared to before, right? So it's faster to have faster memory than it's to have higher clock. So now we're gonna try a Celeron 1 GHz with the 176 MHz bus, right?
Yeah.
So I'm just gonna screenshot this.
Screen.
So, after some trial and error, we got the Celeron Telethon 1 GHz up to 1.76 GHz. Memory is running at 133, I think. This is funny. Is it the wrong slot? Do you see this? It can't read the memory stick settings anymore. The fuck, did we break? I mean, it reads the speeds, but it can't read the SPD. Yeah, we have a 76% overclock right now on a 1 GHz CPU. Let's run some 3D Mark.
Should work anyway.
Har du print screen på den här med, eller?
Jag får inte vara med VK-kortningen.
Jag har inte varit skriven om Peter, men jag ska ju se. Jag orkar inte skriva ner, ta screenshot med GPU på hela kameran. Men vi vet ju, vi kan skriva det fina med bara.
Hoppas min går ju lite så sen där.
Så sätter den där, och så gör jag så. Så screen. Jag tror de postar, men det var upp 100. Ja, men det var 105 postar, inte 103 postar jag tänkte, så 102 gick inte via. Vi kan ju se. Vi kan 176. 177 kan man göra, men jag tänkte att man kan köra den. Det är en fin summa att hamna på. Det måttar, jag kan vara nöjd. Postar man i alla fall.
Ja, 800 blank.
Så man går igen och vill... Sen startar du
lite på. Är det en e-gärsare du känner?
Mm, det är fan.
Det är rätt flåd att köra 800 blank.
Mm, men jag är inte säker på att bota Windows.
Är det värt en... Nej.